Hello, my friends. This is Wolfgang with Tools for Ascension, and today it is Question and Answers with Wolfgang from Tools for Ascension by Wolfgang. And probably today the theme is cord cutting, also Draco cord cutting. I'm just to get things started, the process started. You know, to read the comments, you know, and many comments also have questions, and I can do commentary on this. So they're public comments, but, you know, regular questions, you know, sent to me by email are also welcome. All right. So KL asks or reports, my last partner used to joke that she was a vampire. I now realize it was no joke. After our relationship ended, I aged and became critically ill. She admitted to trying to get me to kill myself even, and asked for my forgiveness, which I gave, and I have not heard from her since. So, there are people that know how to vampire energy. It's you know, you can suck somebody dry in a couple of seconds, you know, if you know what you're doing. I'm not going to tell you guys how to do it, but I advise you strongly to stay away from this kind. You know, everybody has their protectors, you know, a whole entourage of ancestors, grandmothers, and, you know, other beings. And they do not take it lightly when you keep stealing the life force from their beloved ones. Okay, so so but it's possible. And of course, you know, especially when you had sex with somebody, you know, there is a strong connection through cordings, very, very strong, and so they have more access to you. And most of the time, you know, the cords can be reattached, so you have to just, you know, go through your chakras and either just, you know, disconnect on a regular basis or you become so sensitive that you feel when somebody connects to you and just, you know, dissolve it, you know, with intent or prayer. You know, there are lots of methods. All right. So here, this is Chava P. Wolfgang, I immediately went into a lucid dream where this girl I have been obsessed by started to shrivel and was, what was left was a body made up of gray dirty cords. I started levitating and then she turned into a canine with the same structure. She didn't want me to see her and was gaining power until I started chanting Thu. So yeah, Thu is it's like Om, you know, very similar. Basically you have a sinus wave that vibrates and it's you know, entities, subtle entities don't like it, you know, of the darkness. They don't like these kind of things, gongs, conch shells, etc. So I didn't defeat it, and I still feel something on and in my stomach. So I'm wondering if it's really some sort of entity instead of the girl I met briefly over the internet. So yeah, you can, you know, connect to people's, you know, energy. So, you know, on the subtle level, on the astral level, where this, you know, chi transfer happens, there is no distance. You know, that's like how a mother knows, you know, how a child is doing, you know, wherever the child is. You know, this is how, you know, I can project and feel my clients that are thousands of miles away. You know, I have people everywhere, New Zealand, you know, South Africa, Australia, you know, China, actually not yet, you know, but lots in Asia. Anyhow, so, so, but, you know, basically you're being shown, you know, the cords, And many times those courts, you know, come through the generations, through the incarnations, you know, and follow you around. So then she writes, I started levitating, and she turned into a canine with the same structure, so maybe a shape-shifting entity. And she didn't want me to see her. So yeah, you know, generally they try to mess with humans unseen. And you know, it's like we handle chickens, we handle farm animals. You know, some of them are a lot stronger than us. But you know, they don't know how to defeat barbed wires and locked doors in a way, and we take advantage of this, and so there are entities that take advantage of us. I mean, nothing to be scared about, they're already doing it. You know, it's just the question is, you know, how to relate to this, how to defend yourself. Mm-hmm. So she had a fight, and now there's a bad feeling in the stomach, yeah. So you took some energy, some bad energy into this, and you know, it's important to find out, you know, where this comes from, you know, why it's staying there, you know, can you discharge it, can you transmute it, you know, can you try to ground it out or project love into it. You know, I have like several videos on hands-on healing and love meditation, you know, try that. And you know, if it's something more than energy or an energy dump, if it's something more karmic, you know, you either gotta ask questions to your higher self or, you know, book a private question. You know, it depends how severe this is, you know, but of course in a private session, you know, a lot more than just one of those little things is being taken care of. Alright, so I hope this helps. And what do we have here? This is Da and D O then 0 and I. So this looks like formulas. Will this work, this cord cutting video, with cutting cord with an abusive mother? So cord cutting can be applied, you know, but let's say people that you had sex with and people of your own DNA, you know, like mother, father, sisters, they have a special access code, you know, to you. I don't think, you know, it can be completely broken. You know, you can maybe disconnect it and refuse to be connected. It might be better to just heal that wound in the other person, you know, through forgiveness and prayer and projecting of love. You know, this might be the better solution that is expected from the universe instead of just cutting people off. You know, but there's only so much we can do, and people have free will. So, you know, if you're trying to force other people to reform, that's also not the right thing. It would be a violation of free will. And, you know, you create a lot of trouble for yourself, you know, without any returns. Mm-hmm. Better to invest your life force, you know, into worthwhile projects, you know, that will are most uplifting. All right. So, yeah, also, you know, with courting with mothers, you know, if you grow up in her stomach, you know, you pretty much can assume that you inheriting her emotions, you know, the same emotions, whether it's anxiety or sadness or fear or, you know, because initially you don't know the difference between you and your mother. There's no sense of identity. So, you know, when you become aware, you know, it's time to realize, hey, this is from my mom. This is not really what I, what I'm supposed to carry. You know, this is not me. This is not my, for my soul. You know, and it's just like, you know, the curtains she gave you, you know, you didn't like, you know, you can just, you know, release it. Right. Okay. So, and also this is here on Divine Child, cord cutting. Wolfgang, my friend, this is a powerful meditation indeed. I ended up crying when the spirits and archangels showed me the faces of the ones reattaching cords to me. I saw magnets all over my body, and that scared me to the point that I started to cry. I will try my best to continue doing this meditation. Hopefully, it will help me being released from these cords. I sent you an email through your website. So, yeah, this is, you know, and many people, you know, there have been certain sacrifices and ceremonies done, you know, to facilitate cords better. There are levels of cording from the Anunnaki, and then there are levels of cording from the Alpha Draconian, and, you know, of course, the Zetas and other beings, you know, that are service to self, you know, they might take advantage, you know, of your abilities, of your life force, etc. You know, through technologies, you know, at the moment, we probably have no clue how it works, but, you know, those things seem to exist. Okay, and this is from I Am She. This is about the Draco cord cutting. Sorry, I just wondered why you refer to them as the Alpha Draconian in the description. You are a beacon of light in the vast darkness to many people who are searching for the way back to safety. You have such a powerful platform from which to shine your light in all directions, to the many transmuters of energy that have forgotten their purpose and their way. Please use your words as if they were light themselves to guide and educate. You know, education means liberation and empowerment. Actually, it means to lead out. Words such as alpha could create fear and could give the wrong message in so many ways. Lead by example, divine one, much love, family of light. So, yeah, should we tell scary stories, you know, and should we? Well, when you're in fear, you know, you shut yourself off from love and support. So, but to know about dangers that are existing, you know, and know more about it, you know, liberates you from fear, right? That I just, let's say, when, you know, my son was very small and there was we had a hot oven, I just, you know, guided his hand slowly towards the oven, closer and closer and closer. He got the point, you know, that it's hard to touch the oven. You know, there was no preaching necessary. You know, he was intelligent enough to get it right away. So, you know, we don't have to, and he was not afraid of the oven either, you know, and so I wasn't afraid that he would touch the oven, you know, maybe have an accident, fall onto it. So, it's, sorry about the ovens. But, you know, this is part of waking up, you know, that these realities exist. And then, you know, you gotta deal with it. It's just like Jesus, you know, met the devil, you know, in the desert, right? So, yeah, Martin Luther, you know, when he was starting to translate the Bible into German, you know, he also had an encounter, you know, with one of those devils, you know, Alpha Draconians. So, you know, this is part, you know, where everybody that's waking up has to deal with this. This, you know, and should not be like taken as a hush-hush topic, you know, with fear surrounding, you know. No, it's just a fact of life. It's like the same way that you don't play on the highway. No, it's right? Okay. So, but, you know, you are right, and I love this, you know, language is light. So, now here we have from I was an Egyptian in a past life, you know, regarding Draco cord cutting. Dearest Wolfgang, I'm being called to learn the mysteries of dragon energy, you know, the good kind. I was pleasantly surprised to learn that ley lines are also called dragon lines, you know. Ancient cultures across the planet have many beliefs and legends involving dragons. Well, let me just stop here, you know. So dragon lines, you know, I think dragon has been used in different cultures for different things. You know, for instance, when you look at a mountain range, many times it looks like a big dragon that's laying down, you know, so you have this kind of roof-like structure and maybe it tapers out, you know, where you could imagine the tail and maybe one end, you know, is the head. And, you know, believe it or not, you know, those mountains, they have a personality, they're intelligent, they're very smart. You know, humans just come and go for them, you know, they see huge cycles and they're very, very intelligent. And you could consider, you know, this consciousness as a dragon consciousness, right? Because these are like very wise, long-lived beings and they're full of treasures, you know, growing on them and also in them. So, then, of course, in Chinese or Asian mythology, you know, dragons are, you know, spirits, you know, the spirit beings. In other cultures, they might be called yin or jin, you know, and then, of course, you know, there are a whole slew of reptilian beings that live on the subtle planes. Which, you know, could be the Naga people, which are, you know, snake. They have snake-like skin. They have, some of them, you know, have like a snake-like underbody, but humanoid tops. And they're described already in the Vedas, you know, in the Mahabharata. They're being described as having interaction with the humans. And, you know, some have legs, so, you know, you have different types of models there, and also, according to the Vedas, you know, they're described as being shapeshifters. So they can appear as a human, you know, as long as they please, some of them at least, you know, the evolved class, you could say. And so, and then you have all types of reptilian, you know, branches also, you know, that have evolved. And then the Alpha Draconians are more like a parrot star race. They are going from planet to planet. And so they are like the bad guys, and they're probably considered the devil of the Bible. You know, they have the aristocracy of them has a little wings. And so they're like in hut, you know, and subterranean, so the hell down below. So there seem to be a lot of parallels there, you know. And they're described in the Vedas as Rakshasas, and there have been huge battles with them, you know, the whole Ramayana or Ramayana depends, you know, being pronounced different. You know, it's just a story of a battle with Rakshasas, you know, that had taken over a stronghold in Sri Lanka. This was in a time when there was still a land bridge. Okay, and actually I had past life regressions with people that were part of the army. So, interesting. All right. So my light just flickered. And so, and then she's asking, I'm having difficult finding information of much spiritual substance. With much respect and a heart filled with divine love, I ask you, dear Wolfgang, if you have any insight on dragon energy in regards to ascension. Your wisdom is a treasure to earth. Thank you for everything. Well, well, the wisdom that comes, the wisdom has been given to me by just, you know, witnessing all the wisdom from the high selves that I've asked, you know, to explain things to me. So, And, you know, are draconians or dragons, you know, good or bad? And again, there is a lot of fear around this. And basically saying they're good and bad is like saying it's racism. You know, it's just like humans are good or bad, or New Yorkers are good or bad. And it's just, you know, oh, race is good or bad. You know, this is just racism. You know, there might be tendencies, you know, in certain races, you know, maybe genetically or culturally, you know, formed. But I have encountered, you know, in my soul searches and regression work, draconian reptilian beings that came from unconditional love. And, you know, absolutely, and you know, very wonderful, very wise being, you know, that also, you know, incarnated as humans and, you know, came to serve and you know, transmute back karma, etc. So, and also, let's say, when the battle against the Rakshasas in Sri Lanka was won by the, you could say, Pleiadians, probably, not Ram, the green one. You know, they installed some nice Rakshasas, you know, that were loving and had a different nature, you know, volunteer. So so that is scriptural that, you know, they're just like beings, like everyone else, it seems, you know. Who knows how much free will is always involved. Anyhow. So yeah, so the right dragons, you know, they all can help you. I would say, you know, it's whatever helps you to ascend and to raise your vibration, you know, to accept that, you know, and so you just want to use the most efficient methods, you know, where there is no price to pay, let me put it like this, all right? Okay, so... And then here, this is from Auto Light Language Kristallin, also regarding Draco cord cutting. Thank you so much, dear Wolfgang. I felt so many snaps and blockages move. Some took until the last part. Feeling cured of depression and which came over me recently. So yeah, snaps and crackles. So this is kind of, let me just stop here, you know, this is an observation, you know, I had so many times. I mean, I lived, you know, for 12 years in ashrams, you know. So when people's kundalini comes up or they're just going into higher energetic states of consciousness, you know, the spine, you know, it's not adjusted properly. So for like higher energy flow, you'd have to adjust it, and then automatically, you know, people start cracking their neck or moving their spine, you know, and then you kind of know, oh yeah, so the kundalini is kind of coming up, and so they're just, you know, tweaking their energy system, you know, to facilitate, you know, better conductivity, let me put it like that. Mm-hmm. So, you know, so whenever you have crackling and popping, you know, you have a release actually on the physical plane, you know, I would say. And, you know, there is this thing, you know, where you kind of pop, you know, the toes or fingers. And so I noticed, you know, after toes are popped, you know, there is some much better chi flow through there, you know, and when the chi flow is proper, you know, you can't pop the toe. You know, I mean, of course, there is a proper way, you know, if you pull and push hard enough, you know, every toe pops, but so it has something to do, you know, with chi flow. So, and you know, also, you know, Reich, you know, he talks about this, you know, he had this half barrel thing that people would lean over, you know, and then, you know, sometimes, you know, they would pop something. And there would be an energy release. Some people would go into past life trauma, past life regression, you know, into past life where the trauma happened, let's say where they got their back busted or whatever happened there. So, you know, it can be done, you know, from the physical, you know, to the spiritual, or from the spiritual to the physical. And So you felt depressed, and many times, you know, I mean, depression is basically having a big pain body. You know, many people have pain bodies from, you know, a difficult birth. Some people have a pain body, you know, inherited from their mom, you know. And so, yeah, my mom was suicidal, you know, when she was pregnant with me, you know, and for good reasons. So I'm not blaming, you know, it's just, so they had a lot to transmute. So I know what it is, you know, so I'm not an armchair philosopher here. So, yeah, so when you get rid of that pain, somehow transmute the pain, you know, your depression is gone, right? And depression, you know, people that are depressed, you know, breathe very shallow, you know, and people, of course, that are excited about life, you know, they breathe very deep. Oh, life is so great. Life is black and white. Yeah, you don't have any juice, you know, you don't have any chi, you know. The more chi you have, the more vibrant the colors become, you know, and then when you go into higher vibration, you know, you can probably see more the luminous aspect, you know, of you know, the reality. Feeling cured of depression, which came over me recently. I saw some other me being freed. I wonder what this will do to their lives. I have the feeling I have to do this meditation 3 times today. What would be the reason for that, I wonder? Well, first of all, you probably released like a soul fragment, you know, of your, or you could consider it also like a ghost aspect, you know, from a past lifetime that was for some reason stuck, you know. Many times they're stuck because of cording, you know, or chains that keep them bound, you know. It's a black magic thing, sometimes maybe promises or attachment, you know, to their treasures that they had, you know. Sometimes it's attachment to people, sometimes to land, sometimes, you know, to actual treasures, so, or for revenge, you know, screwing somebody's life, you know, up. So, and so at least, you know, here, so you could release some ghost, and many times those ghosts are very traumatized, and that's the first reason why they get stuck. And so, but then, you know, by resonance, you know, so you feel their depression, you feel their pain, you know, many times you have like neck pains, or because they have neck pains, or, you know, your right leg hurts because, you know, they had problem with their right leg. And when the ghost is gone, you know, the trauma is gone right there. So, you know, anyway, I will do so. Thank you very, very much. With a glow and loving heart, hug me. Thank you. Okay, now here, oh, the no. So I did the meditation 3 times yesterday. I felt each separate meditation work very deep. That's good. The first one cut the huge cords and straightened my spine a lot. The second one removed a huge object from my throat and more. And the third one removed a blindfold from the third eye. I think he means a blindfold. Mr. Fatfinger just got in there, I guess. So, okay. So, yeah. So, basically, you know, you're definitely going from layer to layer, you know. And so there are different, you know, layers of sabotage or harvesting that is happening, right? So first they took the crude stuff out, you know, and your spine, you know, is has a better energy flow. And just like in the Matrix where they're plugged into on the spine, along the spine, you know, this is pretty much how cordings are, but not mechanical, you know, they're subtle. And, you know, and they're just more organic, you know, looking. Much more organic looking, you know, they're not tech in any way. And so, on the second one, a huge object from my throat and more was removed. So, from the throat, that's one favorite spot of harvesting energy because it's very pre-digestive. It's a very high quality of energy. It's connected with creativity, you know, but refined, not to a crude creativity like sexuality. No, this is the artist, you know, creativity, the refined stuff. And so, this is a, you know, a more sophisticated kind of, you know, sucking new energy. And then, you know, they removed the blindfold from the third eye, and this has been done especially in Egypt. You know, many priests and priestesses were fooled into giving up, you know, their sovereignty in exchange for psychic powers, and the opposite kind of happened. You know, they got these blindfolds, you know, and other things implanted there. Or just the energy stolen, you know, on some kind of bogus contract. And, you know, I have many clients where this is being removed nowadays, you know, and just their communication with their high self improves, you know, tremendously. So, yeah. So, and of course, you know, they always try to block, you know, your third eye vision, otherwise you could figure out what's going on. Also, third eye has been like a standard, you know, in all good old times, you know, when there was, let's say, psychological warfare going on between kingdoms and or just intrigues, you know. One of the first thing is, you know, cut off the communication, you know, to the high self, you know, and cut off the vision, you know, so don't get any guidance anymore, you know. So that's how you sabotage somebody. And so there is generally a lot there, you know. That's one of the reasons why humans are not that psychic anymore. They are psychic, but it has been, you know, covered over with a lot of dark stuff, you know. And this is time to wake up to this, you remove it, and then you're back to love and light. You know, it's no love and light when you have a dead rat under the couch. It's not going to work very much. All right. So he got this blindfold removed from his third eye, and it gave him back soul parts like this here. Yeah, this is nice, you know. So yeah, when the soul parts come back, that is really good. You know, I mean, you can feel it. It's, you know, I experience this a lot. You know, I feel when this happens to my clients when we call them in. And, you know, it's just like a little bit like in the quickening, you know, maybe not the thunder and lightning, but, you know, you just suddenly, you know, you, along your spine, you get all this energy and it just fills out your aura more. And so these are all parts of the soul that kind of say, I'm out of here, you know, in past lifetimes, you know, when, you know, they were very miserable situations. You know, they're like, I'm not dealing here, I'm too fine for this, it's too crude, you know, I'm not going to be a slave to this or that, you know, and that part left, you know. And so, you know, it's like a more maintenance crew, you know, not the full soul is present anymore. So, you know, you have a really dumbed down version, and when these higher aspects come back, you know, you get smarter, you know. That's kind of, you know, how you can explain a genius level, you know. And many of those kids, they come in with a much higher set or percentage of their higher self manifesting through them. So back to him here. So I finally slept in a good place again and had good dreams with animals and lotus flowers. I've been having nightmares and bad sleep for a while. Yeah. So actually in the Vedas, when they describe the places where, you know, the higher dimensional places where yogis live, you know, they're always by a lake with lotus flowers, with birds chirping and beautiful trees and deer coming, you know, not being afraid. You know, it's just and a simple place to live. You know, it's always, you know, the beauty of nature, you know, the beauty of the smell of nature, the sounds of nature, the colors, You went to the kind of heavenly planets, it's called, you know, they call them lokas. You know, it's not necessarily a place in physical space, more like in astral space, in subtle space, you know, subdimensions, you could say. Mm-hmm. So, and, you know, yeah, nightmares, there's some negative entities, they love to poke you with nightmares. It's like some, you know, kids, they love to poke worms and torture maybe a dog or a cat or some other animal. You know, they love that power, that sense of power. But they're also these beings, they get a high, you know, of your fear. You know, this adrenaline, you know, it's like, you could say, cooked to them. You know, so they get, you know, hyped up from that. You know, they can't really digest love and light. It's distasteful for them, you know. They want something nasty. You know, something really fearful. And so, you know, some of them, they can, you know, project imagery into your mind. And when you're not aware, you know, in your dream, you know, suddenly you find yourself in a nightmare. And, you know, you're naked, you get chased around in New York by drug dealers in Harlem. And do this, like, you know, throughout the night, you know. So, you know, you wake up exhausted, you know, from all this anxiety. And so that I had a good time harvesting your energy, right? So, of course, I mean, there are other interpretations of dreams, but, you know, there are these kind of nightmares, you know, where they just rake you over the coals and just, you know, harvest your fear. Okay. So, and then he goes, on this morning I got up fit before sunset, which is also a surprise, took the dog for a 2-hour walk, no coffee needed. So, yeah, I mean, you got rid of a lot of stuff. And actually, you know, 4 o'clock in the morning, you know, the Hindus call this the Brahma Muhurta. And this is like the ether, the subtle plane, you know, where the emotions and the thought forms are, is the calmest then, you know, on the whole 24-hour cycle. From 4 to 5 to 6, you know, that's the calmest time. And so that's a good time, you know, to meditate, you know, or to open yourself up. You know, there's not so much interference and noise, astral noise around, all right? So, and no coffee. So I normally take 2 strong coffee and dreading to go out for hours until I go and then walk maybe 30 minutes. A big difference. Yeah, I think your dog also loves you a lot more. And I feel so amazingly relieved. Thank you so much. I'm planning to book a consult with you, if only to thank you in person, but I also have some questions. Yeah, so, you know, I'm open, you know, to help people. I do not charge very much, anyhow. So you know what to do. Now, this is from Sam Freda, and regarding Draco cord cutting. First of all, thank you. You spoke to my soul, and it has been buried for a long time. Tears streamed down my face. Very, very powerful meditation. Let's hope I see some changes. Well, I tell you, you know, with tears streaming down your face, you know, in those meditations, when I guide them, I cry, you know, many times, you know. And crying is a sign of, you know, strong emotions, right? And, you know, of course, this transfers, you know, these strong emotions, you know, you feel them too. So, you know, it's kind of a joint experience, but, you know, you probably can't see it because you always have the cutaways. To give me some privacy, you know, but I cry many times too. So, anyhow. Secondly, when you spoke about dreamtime visitation, I recalled a dream I've never been able to shake because it was so otherworldly. I wanted to share with you, and maybe you could tell me if it is something you recognize. I always wondered if it was an actual being that came to me and not my imagination dreaming. Okay, I found myself in a dark room that I could sense was very massive, bigger than any room or building I've ever been in, wide open and mostly empty. I couldn't see anything besides the being I will mention in a minute. I could only sense the enormity of the room. It was pitch black. The presence of an alien about 100 yards, which is 300 feet, maybe in front of me, looking at me. Now, this thing was terrifying looking. I can't remember it, although I was not afraid. It looked like something from a movie, just grotesque. It communicated with me telepathically and made me feel safe. Mm-hmm. It then pulled me to it, or it somehow moved, or I somehow moved toward it, without the sensation of walking, just a point A to point B. I do feel like I went willingly. So this is, let me just tell you, on the astral plane, where these things can be done. You can will yourself to float somewhere, but in this case, this being, just willed yourself, and also it just gave you like a calming thing, just chill out, you're safe. Right, so it has those mental powers, this being, It opened this cage-like apparatus in front of its body, almost like wings, but on the front, and closed me under them up against its body. We then shot up into the sky very, very fast into the atmosphere and past Earth, and I watched Earth from above. That's what stood out to me about this dream. I've never seen Earth like this in a dream, and it was so beautiful. Well, this is not a dream. This is astral travel. This is kind of something, that, Eliza, and other people, that, contactees, they're nowadays called, not abductees. Abductee is against the will, and this seems to be more like a contactee. You weren't freaking out, this is a positive thing. So he shows you the beauty of this planet, so he's not trying to scare you here, And so, I wasn't afraid. I had the sense that we were going to school almost. I don't know how else to describe it. Yeah, you learn. Look at this beautiful jewel, this is how you learn. Not through remembering by route. I've never been able to shake that dream. I've looked online for anything similar. I remember the alien well. It was very tall, 9 or 10 feet or more feet tall. Very ugly, laugh not loud anyway. I hope that's not my brethren. Maybe it is. And there are benevolent beings that look like that. Or maybe they were malevolent and I was under spell. Well, no, this wasn't a malevolent vision. This was a very benevolent vision. The malevolent, they don't care whether you freak out. They actually rather have you freak out and fall apart. So, no, this was a kind one. And, there are, what is hideous, right? This is always a question. So we might look very hideous, to them with our pink, thin skins, no patterns, like they have, wonderful scales and patterns there, So they might consider us ugly and hideous, being like little mice or pink. So there are dragons, that fight with Alpha Draconians, and you could be incarnated as one of those. It's very likely. Probably Alpha Draconian would not treat you like that, but many of us also have been incarnated as Alpha Draconians or still incarnated as Alpha Draconians. It depends on your soul. So some of us have very, very powerful souls, very old souls, and they are incarnated in all the major star races that are involved here. You know, so they have their finger in all the pies. And you know, you're not just only Lyran, or you're not just only like Andromedan or Pleiadian. You know, you are many, many people are incarnated in all kinds of races and all kinds of dimensions. So that definitely was not your imagination. You know. Imagination, you know, in imagination you're making up what you already know. Or I mean, you mean that your imagination is actually your pie chart, you know, where, you know, you get a visual representation of whatever, you know, you're supposed to understand or see. You know, whether it's astral travel or seeing energies, you know, you can ask, you know, to see on a certain level or what you want, and then boom, you see it. You know, these the military, you know, and spy programs, they do so, you know, and I've had clients, you know, go back to past lifetimes in primitive men or in ancient men, not primitive at all, or in dinosaurs and other beings. You know, it's very, very enlightening, you know, to first-hand experience, you know, in those bodies. Anyhow, so this was good, don't be afraid, you know. And if you get afraid, just ask, you know, for God, Archangel Michael, or Jesus to protect you, and you're going to be okay, you know. The bad ones will back off as soon as you call the heavy hitters in, all right? And this is from Alexandra, and she says, this was a really nice meditation. I could feel it lift me up, definitely. I see the pattern of emotional vulnerability and the energy snowballing. This will be most definitely a helpful tool in my ascension. It was interesting that during the first prompt in the meditation, there was a loud bang of fireworks outside my window, and my downstairs neighbor's television set got louder. In synchronicity, we see explanation of coding. So, yeah, synchronicity. The higher your vibration becomes, and you know, the more aware you become, the more you see the synchronicity. You know, so see that you're looking at the digital clocks, and you see like 1, 2, 3, or 11, 11, or 2, 2, 2, 2. You know, all kinds of, you know, synchronicity you become aware of. You know, first of all, because you are aware. And also, you know, it's kind of a sign that your high self and your crew, you know, your higher dimensional entourage, you know, let you know, that you're having your back, you know, that you're in touch, you know. Like, hey, look, we made you look at this, you know, this is just, hey, we're there, you know, just a tip to the head, you know, that you're connected. And so it's, oh yeah, you know, sometimes the animals come in. You know, like a hawk dive bombs on you, happened to me. And then, you know, you have to pay attention, you know, what did you think at that time when this happened? You know, with one client, you know, we found out that that client was cursed, you know, with a jinn. And so we were just, you know, discussing and asking, you know, so okay, so if you offer you some cigarettes and some booze, you know, you're gonna you're gonna leave, right, not come back. And the whole house went black. The whole neighborhood went dark. So, you know, it became apparent that, you know, buying of gins like this is not a good idea. And of course, you know, we later on in the electricity came back. He checked with high self, and yeah, it was not a good idea. And but it just became very obvious, you know, very, very obvious. You know, these are called omens, you know. I mean, an omen is, for instance, you know, you're in a street and there are a lot of old cars there, you know, with bullet holes. in the window and the radio is gone, you know, then it is an omen that this is not a very good neighborhood, you know. So sometimes it becomes very clear, and we, just because we can rationalize it, you know, how can this be? How can this happen? You know, this is so unlikely. You know, we're looking for a rational reason, and that the world is magical, you know, ultimately. You know, this is, it's too unlikely, you know, to happen. The world is actually magical. All right, one more. This is Shishi09. It's also regarding Draco cord cutting. Thank you. I can breathe freely. The constriction in my lungs and throat is gone. And I feel so much lighter. My head moved the entire meditation. So this is that head cranking again, you know. When, you know, you basically, your physical body can upgrade because the force field that was having a, you know, not so good pattern, you know, has changed, and now, you know, we can upgrade. So verification for me that this is of the divine creator of all. Yes, I try to align with this. Otherwise, you know, it's a lot of struggle. So it's must to, you know, to get with the higher management, you know, the best higher management, you know, and align with this. And how do you know? You know, it by the results. You know by the results, you know, you feel lighter, better, more loving, more connected to Source, or not. You know, and whatever connects you to Source and to love, you know, do that. You know, that's the principle, you know, you can't be wrong, I guess. All right. So, welcome, and welcome home. This is, oh God, yeah, one more then. Draco cord cutting. This is the best spiritual experience I've ever had. Thank you. I feel like a newborn. I'm in shock and amazed at once. Yeah, so, you know, how do we know, you know, that is not just some mental game, you know, some kind of a con? Well, as again, you know by the results, you know. So maybe it is a mental con, you know, but it works, you know. Placebo works 40%. You know, many drugs, you know, they maybe work, you know, 45% of the time or 55% of the time, you know, plus they have side effects. So they're barely better than placebo, and then who knows, you know, how much of Eisenstein's observation, you know, who was this now, you know, has affected those experiments, you know, all those labs were funded, right? So there were certain expectations. So, you know, again, you know, whenever you have this strong emotional response, you know something works, you know, especially if you feel lighter and better, you know, it worked. And you didn't have to take a pill or a drug, you know, and it's clean, you know, it's healthier. All right, so that's for today. I love you, you know, subscribe, ring the bell, and get private sessions and smile like an idiot. Namaste.